Teneo, ooh, na, na. All of my heart is in Teneo, ooh, na, na. Boutique to luxury, Teneo, ooh, na, na. Beaches and islands, homie, then ski the mountains only at Teneo, ooh, na. Let's talk about the Teneo difference.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
20 networking events each year and
oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Teneo is built on relationships.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Connecting meeting planners with the best hotels like
ooh,
300 member hotels and DMCs worldwide.
Ooh,
300 member hotels and DMCs worldwide.
Teneo, ooh, na, na.
All of my heart is in Teneo, ooh, na, na. Boutique to luxury, Teneo, ooh, na, na. Beaches and islands, homie, then ski the mountains only at Teneo, ooh, na, na.
All right. Well, welcome, everybody. Thanks for joining us for yet another Teneo Hospitality Showcase. We're excited to have you all with us today for a little Teneo Unana. I'm Jamie Bruce. I'll be our host today and take us on a journey around some of our fabulous resorts. We were featuring three classic resorts that we're really proud to have as a member of Teneo Hospitality. And we've got some great story to share with you today on these three exceptional resorts. I'm calling you today from beautiful, sunny, currently sunny, somewhat sunny Orlando, Florida. Best of luck to anybody here on the East Coast in the past in the path here to Hurricane Helene. But so far so good. But let's just to tell you a little bit about the group we're presenting today. So we're going to start off on the southeast in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, resort Pier 66 that certainly has a long history, but closed in 2019 and has been completely reimagined, an entirely new project. And we're excited to learn all about that today. Then we're going to venture over to the Hill Country to the phenomenal La Cantera Resort in San Antonio, Texas, celebrating about 25 years of Texas hospitality and continuing to reinvent themselves and create brand new experiences for groups and conventions. And we're excited to hear all about that today. And then we're going to wrap up with the iconic Boca Raton. It's only been around since, I think, 1929 or something like that. We're going to get all the facts, but there's certainly been a new life that's been injected into the Boca Raton just in the last couple of years with brand new ownership who's invested significantly into revitalizing the Boca Resort. And today we're going to spend a bit of time talking about the beach club, their specific beach club property within the Boca Resort. So without further ado, let me introduce our distinguished speakers today. So with us today from Pier 66, we've got Brett Boring and Jim Bishop, who are going to talk us through the Pier 66 Resort. Then over in Texas, we've got Jonathan Falloon, and we also have Colleen Klein behind the scenes answering questions in the chat. We're thrilled to have them with us today. And then finally at Boca, we've got Katie Jordan, and behind the scenes with Katie is Jason Kalman, who are gonna answer some of the questions that might pop up in the chat. And so on that point, just a couple of reminders, please stay engaged. We can see a lot of activity in the chat room already. Ask your questions. We'll try to get everything answered as we go. At the end of each session, we'll do a quick Q&A. And then please pay attention. There's going to also be a trivia question, and lucky winners of the right answers for each question will get a chance to perhaps take a visit to one of these spectacular resorts. And in the end, we'll wrap all this up. We will be sharing the presentation with you afterwards. We'll wrap up those details at the end. So why don't we go off to Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Jim, Brett, take it away.
Thank you, Jamie, and really honored to be a part of the Teneo and certainly a part of this group. It's crazy when you think about how small of an industry it is, but this group in particular today is special to me because La Cantera happens to be my alma mater. And Boca is my alma mater. So this feels like a class reunion / family reunion, right? In some ways. And Jamie and I worked together back in the day at Doral as well. So yeah, definitely small industry.
All right. Well, we'll get rolling.
All right. So we're going to talk a little bit about the history.
Yeah, so many of you may know about Pier 66. I know from a regional perspective, it has a long lineage and a legendary status. But the reason it's Pier 66 is because back in 1957, there was a gas station right on the marina, and it actually was owned by Phillips Petroleum, aka Phillips 66. And so over the course of the years, it began to become more popular. All the way up to one of the largest super yacht marinas in the world today. But in 1965, still owned by Phillips Petroleum, they built a very unique tower along with that Jetsons allure, as well as mid-century modern. They erected the tower and immediately became a celebrity hangout. So you had the whole Rat Pack crew here with Blue Eyes, et cetera. And then over the years, you had Jackie Gleason, Cary Grant, very, very famous and known for its rotating tower on top, which I'm excited to announce that it will rotate yet again. So throughout the years, it continued to be regionally famous. At one point, it was independent, then Hyatt had it, and then for a brief time, it was independent again. And then as what can happen in South Florida from time to time, a hurricane rolled through, and this hurricane's name was Irma, and she literally totaled the resort. I've heard of a totaled car, but this is the first time I've ever heard of a totaled resort. So at that point, owned by our current ownership, Tavistock, they took a break, and they said they wanted to really reinvent it. And originally, it was going to be a four-diamond aspiration. And so they started to break ground on March 12th of 2020. And if that rings any bells, that was like literally about 2 weeks before the entire world shut down. So at that point, they had construction for a week, then let that go. And then during that time, which is to our benefit, they went from a four diamond, four star aspiration to a five diamond, five star aspiration. And what you're about to see and what is about to be finished, we're literally weeks away from our temporary occupancy, is the result of that. So without further ado, I'll pass it on to Jim.
We're going to talk a little bit about location. All right, so what you've seen obviously from some of the images and now this rendering that you're seeing right now, Fort Lauderdale, it is known as the Venice of the Americas. And I've lived in Florida for 11 years, but I live in Palm Beach County, so a little bit further north. And until taking on this role, I did not realize like truly how much the water is really at the essence and being on the water is at the essence of this destination. So hundreds of miles of canals and waterways within greater Fort Lauderdale. And so as far as location from a standpoint of air access or accessibility, you can see up on the screen, we're just 5 miles from Fort Lauderdale International Airport. So that is, you're looking at a 10 or a 15 minute transfer from the airport. And to put that into dollars, that's usually about a $15 or a $20 Uber or Lyft ride. And then we're centrally located between Miami Airport and Palm Beach International Airport. You can see the mileage distance. So lots of airlift into the destination. And then for the folks that are familiar, we do have a high-speed train system called Brightline that goes from Miami all the way to Orlando. So very easy for your folks that are moving within the state of Florida. You can hop on really that high-speed train and move between the destinations. And then as far as local attractions, we're less than a mile from the beach. The convention center, Fort Lauderdale Convention Center, which is going through an expansion right now, is a mile away. And then the cruise port, Port Everglades, 3 miles, downtown Fort Lauderdale as well, 3 miles, and then Las Olas, which is most synonymous with the entertainment, shopping, dining district in Fort Lauderdale, just a few miles away, which is accessible either from the water or ground transfers. So because we have our own marina, we do have our own water taxi stop, a great way to get from the property to that Las Olas area would be on the water. So then next slide, please. All right, we will be talking about our indoor meeting and event space. And then we have some renderings and images of our outdoor meeting and event space in a moment. So really some of these renderings that you see up on the screen, lots of natural light throughout all of our indoor event space. High ceilings, 14 feet is the lowest ceiling you'll find in any of our smaller breakout rooms. And then for our ballrooms, they range 19 feet and up to 23 feet. So lots of natural light, high ceilings, 30,000 square feet total indoor meeting space, which is all on one level. And our banquet kitchen is also located on that same level and easily accessible by your overnight hotel guests. All of the guest room elevators come down to the lobby level, which is also where the ballrooms are located. They come off of those elevators. If they turn in one direction, they'll go directly into the ballroom space. If they turn in another direction, they go to the pools, the marina, the restaurants, et cetera. So very easy to navigate your way around the property. I will mention that technology is really an important aspect in all of our event spaces. So all of the ballroom salons, whether you know they're divisible with air walls, pooled, et cetera, every single ballroom salon has a drop-down screen and a drop-down projector. And then the smaller breakout rooms that range from 800 to 1,000 square feet in size all have large, high-definition monitors, so 105-inch monitors in those. So we'll talk a little bit about the outdoor event space next. All right, so we're very blessed to be located right on the Intracoastal Waterway, 32 acres. So it's quite a large footprint. Right on the gateway to Fort Lauderdale on the Intracoastal Waterway. So we have multiple pool decks, multiple lawn spaces, and the fact that we have this 32-acre footprint, there are even some areas around the resort that as sales folks and our catering folks, we're really looking around and getting creative on how we can activate even some other areas around the resort. That you know, we'll work with our operations teams and make sure that we're you know selling turnkey options to you, but very compelling and exciting outdoor options. Brett's going to talk a little bit later about some of our bars and restaurants on property, but some of those certainly would be available for on-property privatization or on-property dine arounds. All right, the floor plan that you have here, this really sort of wraps up the discussion around the flow of the space. So three ballrooms, the largest of which is just under 10,000 square feet in size. That's Tavistock Ballroom. That's the one right in the middle there. Divides into three equal salons. And then one of those thirds, if you will, subdivides. Coral Ballroom is our second largest. That's the one on the left. And it divides into three equal salons. Total, it's 7,200 square feet in size. And then Aviva Ballroom is the one on the right. It's just over 5,000 square feet in size. This one has natural light on two sides and has an attached event lawn called Aviva Lawn. So really terrific flow of space. And then you can see along the top of that diagram, all of those rooms, breakout spaces, offices. We do have a green room, like a speaker ready room called Rose that has its own bathroom and has closed circuit TV access into the ballrooms. So that if you have a VIP speaker, et cetera, that's what they'll be monitoring the proceedings. So that's everything on one level and really flows very easily between those spaces. All right, moving over to the guest rooms and suites. So 325 total rooms and suites in the property. So we have the original iconic 17-story tower that Brett touched on at the beginning of the presentation. So we did a full gut renovation of that tower down to the concrete pillars and the exterior walls, basically, and rebuilt the entire interior. When it opened back in the 1960s, it was actually the tallest building in Fort Lauderdale. And we do have a historic designation from the city of Fort Lauderdale. So 325 total rooms and suites. You can see some of the renderings here. So it's really a mix of mid-century modern and some Art Deco touches. The entry-level guest room at the property averages 430 square feet in size, so very spacious rooms. And every single room and suite in the property has an outdoor terrace. So sizable terraces, full furniture packages out there. So really, and nearly all of the entire inventory of the property has some sort of water view. So really terrific room product. You see the larger rendering there is the combined living dining area of our presidential suite, which is on the 15th floor.
And Jim will talk a little bit later about our residential component that's in addition to the 325 keys that we have. But I would say if there's anything that we will be most proud of, in addition to our location and such a beautiful physical plant, is our food and beverage programming. Both our ownership, Tavistock, as well as Coral Tree, has a very, very rich history. We have done anything from taco bars all the way up to Michelin status, and that's on both ends, both entities. So we've really come together throughout the program. We actually have four Michelin chefs that have been working on the food and beverage programming. And so we have 12 outlets, actually 12.5 if you count our new candy and chocolate shop that we're opening as well. And so you go, it goes anywhere from a marina side, what we call a high-end dive bar or a designer dive bar, all the way up to Michelin aspiration and everything in between. So what you see here down below, of course, Pier Top is the most legendary. That's in the large image up top, but a very, very nice and elevated coffee bar that will have coffee art, cold pressed juices, French baguette sandwiches that are wrapped in the nice little wax paper. Our pastry chef, half our culinary team speaks French, so I'm still trying to learn what if they're talking about me or not in front of the room. But it's a terrific group of professionals to have. But Elate is our coffee shop. The Nectar Room is on our adult pool. That's a little bit more of an Asian inspired. So tiki drinks, sushi, sashimis, ponzu, et cetera there. And then Garni is it's a very unique concept. It is all day brunch. So both during the breakfast and lunch periods, Garni will be available for an all day brunch. So you'll have both your savory lunch items as well as your breakfast items. And then Soda Grande, which is the last one on this page, there's more than one page of food and beverage. Soda Grande is an Eastern Mediterranean that's right on the marina. As with most of our food and beverage outlets, we have accordion doors, so it's outdoor in, indoor out. If it's too warm, we close the doors to have air conditioning. If the weather's just right, like it generally is, then we'll have it open to have an indoor-outdoor space there. And I've just got a few more to tell you about. So Salt Breeze is on our main pool. That is a Latin-inspired, so you could look for shrimp tacos, ceviches, as well as some amazing tequilas and margarita concoctions coming out of there. Of course, Caluso, is our Michelin aspiration. And that is really where you're gonna see the magic happen from a culinary perspective and hence all the French and Michelin folks that we have coming in. And then of course, there's Pier Top. Pier Top will rotate again. It'll rotate once every 66 minutes. Really more of a high-end cocktail lounge as opposed to a restaurant, but there will be caviar, some raw bar offerings as well up there. But it is absolutely stunning. There are water views, 360 degrees. You see the intracoastal, you see the ocean, you see the cruise ports, absolutely stunning. And then last but not least on this is our lobby bar windows on 66. It's going to be more of a spirits and wine by the glass bar. You will see some allocated bourbon, some allocated white spirits as well, tequilas, a number of different types of agaves there. And then, of course, not listed on here is Pelican Landing, which is also very famous. That is our designer dive bar. It's right on the edge of the marina. You literally have some of the best views on the planet. You can boat ride up and hop in, but it'll have like conch fritters, Pabst Blue Ribbon, burgers, and Louis the 15th. Yeah, that's a little bit of everything. You can have the crew of the yacht in there right alongside the owner of the yacht as well. And that's it for the culinary side. Now we move on to the spa, which is a passion point for me. The same designers of Loma de Vida at La Cantera have been behind this at Zenova. And one of the things that I think is absolutely incredible is that what most people would have as a signature offering, we have all of them. So we have a sensory shower where you literally go through and all your senses are surrounded through water. It's called Via Aqua. And you can go through 9 different stations. There's lighting, there's aromatherapy, there's music, different temperatures, different mists and pulsations of the water designed to slow down your mind. And then we have our ceremony sauna, which there's actually a facilitator. They take this big white snowball of aromatherapy, set it on the rocks, and then they do a ritualistic towel work to spread the heat and the aroma throughout a 12 to 15 minute meditative journey. So the sensory shower takes your mind down to slow, the ceremony sauna takes it to neutral, and then we will have one of the very, very few snow rooms in the United States, one of 3 that we're aware of. So you'll literally go in there. That will be your rejuvenative and restorative therapy. The temperatures range between 10 and 14 degrees. It's a beautiful like cave with 3 inches of snow in there. And that'll really be your restorative therapy. You come back out to the pool, and then the pool will bring you back up to temperature. It is very much wellness. We have one of the best spa directors in the country that is leading this, and we'll be sending out more on our website. You'll learn more about our rituals and the wellness component that's not only in the spa, but woven throughout the entire journey. And that's a little bit about Zenova.
Okay, Brett had done a little teaser there about our resort residences. So I had mentioned earlier that in the hotel inventory, we have 325 rooms and suites. In addition, there are 91 residences on property, 31 of which are located in two low-rise buildings that are right on the water. And the owners of those units will have the option to put them into our rental program. These range from 2 to 4 bedrooms each, so very expansive. And so on top of that 325 room and suite inventory, there's potentially, we're thinking perhaps 15 to 20 mm-hmm. of those owners will opt to put those into our rental program. And again, very expansive residences from 2 to 4 bedrooms and again, right on the water. You'll see it's right on the marina there. And I don't think up to this point we even talked about the capabilities at the marina. 146 slips, mm-hmm. deep water marina. So we can accommodate yachts and vessels up to 400 feet long. So truly anything that's on the water, whether it's from someone wanting to do stand-up paddleboarding or kayaking, all the way up to a mega yacht rental and everything in between, anything that's on the water, your attendees can walk right from their guest rooms to the marina and step on to whether it's a fishing boat or a catamaran sail or a yacht rental and enjoy the Fort Lauderdale on the water lifestyle. So you can see some of the views here from a few of the resort residences. And then on the next slide, you'll see a different perspective of these resort residences 1 and 2, and you'll see how close they are to the hotel towers, et cetera. And they surround the 3 swimming pools that are located sort of nestled in between those buildings. And then the images at the bottom give you some of the decor and the feel of the interiors of these accommodations. Anything to add on the residences?
I think we're good.
Okay.
I think we're good.
And then I think we have a bird's eye view. I think this really can wrap everything into a nice bow for you. So from this view, you can see the full 32-acre footprint of the property. From the marina on your right to those residence buildings that we just showed you, and then the swimming pools, the arrival and the portico share is closer to 17th Street there. I have a beautiful big banyan tree. It's a 200-year-old banyan tree that we have designed and constructed the circular arrival around that as our focal point. Then you see the tallest buildings there are the hotel rooms and suites. And then all of the ballroom and meeting space are tucked there just to the left. And then what's not shown here is to the left along the canal, what is shows a lot of palm trees and vegetation there. We're actually developing that into a space that will have an event lawn. So we'll have a lawn that's in that location that's right on the water, along with some other fun activities like pickleball and some other lawn games and things to do right there on the water. Anything to add?
Yeah, just last in closing, I think if you have not seen Fort Lauderdale, you really don't understand when we say about Venice of the Americas, that the entire community is on the water, of the water. That is a near and dear to our heart. You can literally get to the Atlantic Ocean. It's just outside that screen view, but you can literally get there from probably a quarter mile away out into open water and into the Bahamas if you'd like, cruising through either open water or up and down the intracoastal all the way down to Miami and all the way up to Palm Beach if you'd like. It really is an amazing place to be, the way that you feel, the relaxation. It's more than just a place, it's a way of life. That's it.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you very much. That's a good one. It's a way of life. Well, thank you, gentlemen. Thanks, Brett. Thanks, Jim.
Thank you.
You know, wow, spectacular. You described it in such great detail. I think often we talk about new builds, renovation. This is a brand, as you said, that's been around for a long time, but this is obviously a completely new destination resort, waterfront luxury, and really, you know, a destination resort that Fort Lauderdale's never had. So really kind of transformational for the whole destination. I'm really pleased that you have a 400-foot yacht capability so that the Teneo Hospitality Company yacht can come to town when needed. So I'll be calling up for a slip sometime here in the near future. All right. Well, I saw the chat was really, really active there. I think we were able to capture almost all the questions. If we've missed anything, we'll certainly follow back up with you. But key points, 325 rooms and suites, lots of luxury suite opportunities, 30,000 square feet, great ballroom space, great outdoor space. I don't know how many restaurants you talked about, 12 different food and beverage restaurants there, but which are all a benefit coming to a resort because you have the marina, because you have the residential component there at the property. So really well done. We're excited to have you guys open. Just to be clear, your opening date is?
Well, there's not a day, but there's an ish window, but that would be early December.
Yeah.
Right. But we're very close. Because we're almost at TCO, and that at that point, we'll be able to give you a specific day.
Right. So anybody that's in town, the end of the year, come and see it. Group starting in January. Look forward to having everybody get a chance to get down to Fort Lauderdale and see this wonderful resort. All right. Well, let's go to trivia. Dana, please take us away.
Awesome. Well, we're going to pop up a poll here in a moment that has a question, and we'll get started, and somebody will be able to win a great stay here. So if you see the poll, it's popping up now. Fort Lauderdale is known as the Venice of America. How many miles of canals and waterways are there in the greater Fort Lauderdale area? Wonderful. And Brett and Jim, what is the correct answer?
The correct answer is 300 miles, 300 miles of canals and waterways.
Wow. Well, awesome. Well, so one lucky winner is going to win that great stay to experience this property. Thank you so much. Jamie, back to you.
Fantastic. Thanks, guys. Okay, let's move to the Hill Country of Texas, San Antonio, Texas, to be specific. Jonathan, please take it away. Then you might still be on mute there if you're talking.
There we go. Mute helps, right? You think we've learned that after all these times, right? So, yeah. So thank you, Jamie and Teneo team. Good day, everyone. I want to thank you for joining us. Learn about La Cantera Resort and Spa. My name's Jonathan. I represent the resort as the director of group sales. I spent 16 years in Dallas, but I've been in San Antonio since 2015. And San Antonio is my absolute favorite Texas city. My favorite thing about San Antonio is that you get the best of both worlds, the urban life and the Texas Hill Country. San Antonio has something to offer for everybody. I'd also like to introduce Colleen. Colleen is our director of sales and marketing. Colleen has been with the resort for 16 plus years and started as a front desk agent. Colleen grew up in operations, and I like to think that she is all things La Cantera and a testament to the culture that our team lives each day. And finally, I'd like to introduce La Cantera Resort and Spa. We are an independent resort situated at one of the highest points in San Antonio, with roots in the city and the Hill Country. We truly are an oasis in the city with incredible views and all the conveniences. We're a 496 room resort with a top five destination spa voted by USA Today. That's Loma Nevada Spa and Wellness Center. We also have 18 holes of championship golf, 6 pools, 9 dining options, and 2 years running as the number one resort in Texas and the Southwest voted by Condé Nast. As an independent resort, we have the freedom to think differently. We're never constrained to be ordinary, and we're flexible. We love to say yes. So our time together today is going to be a little limited, but I'm going to try to cover as much as possible. So today I'll highlight why San Antonio. We'll talk about our story. We'll share some exciting news. And then, of course, we'll talk about all the fun stuff and the layout of venue space and how our space makes gatherings better. So why San Antonio? Well, first of all, because San Antonio satisfies all the elements for an incredible experience between culture, cuisine, and charm. Our rich history with Spanish, Mexican, and German influences blended with good old Texas hospitality makes it the perfect destination. Home to the Culinary Institute of America and now a Michelin-rated city, San Antonio is a culinary center and has much to offer for all. And lastly, it's easy to experience it all. Everything is within 20 minutes, from airport to La Cantera, drink in hand, ready to enjoy. While San Antonio is rich with history and culture, La Cantera is full of history and culture too. Having celebrated 25 years this past May, I'd like to take you back to our roots. Some of the images you see on this slide are the inspiration behind the resort. Our design elements were inspired by the main house at the famed King Ranch, which is the largest ranch in the United States at 850,000 acres. The King Ranch is ingrained in our history and continues to inspire us as the property continues to evolve. And we can't wait to tell you about Henrietta. Henrietta was quite the special person and really the individual that made King Ranch what it is today. And we've got some real cool stories to share with you about that. So before we look at the resort and the amenities, I'd like to provide a little perspective on the layout of the resort. While we are situated on 500 acres, the resort is super condensed. It's easy to navigate. The property consists of the main house and the villas, which you'll see on the map just to your left-hand side. Villas at the top right corner, and then, of course, the main house, which is going to be the large campus situated right there in the center. Surrounded by the spa, golf course, signature restaurant, and our newest addition, which I'll tell you about in a few minutes. So while our guest services team is always ready to assist, know that the property is extremely easy to move around. Okay. So let's talk about what's exciting for 2025 and beyond. First and foremost, it's the Condé Nast number one resort in Texas and the Southwest for the last 2 years. We're excited to continue the legacy with offerings of modern comfort, Texas hospitality, and elevated experiences. In June, we kicked off $45 million in guest room improvements. We received our first wave of newly redone rooms in September, and we've received outstanding reviews from our groups that have stayed in these rooms thus far. This project will be complete in January 2025, and the stage is set for guests to experience the reimagined La Cantera Resort and Spa. One of the many things planners love about La Cantera is the option for exclusivity. Buyouts are possible for large groups and small groups. You can claim the whole resort and the venue space, or you can buy out only the villas and or 7 for more intimate groups. When your group buys out the resort, the door is open for unending fun, creativity, and memorable experiences. And with the buyout, you own the space and it opens up a world of branding for you. In simple terms, our brand is your brand. In summary, the total resort includes 496 guest rooms and is made up of the main house and the villas. In the coming slides, we'll look at the various offerings that the resort offers on accommodations, but we'll start here with our deluxe guest rooms. Our new room product features natural materials with rich tones and textures, all inspired by the Texas Hill Country and the King Ranch Estate. Brighten finishes, comfortable seating, modern updates, all to enhance the guest experience. And for further enjoyment, 80% of our guest rooms include a balcony variation, allowing guests to enjoy those peaceful mornings and sunsets. Also located in the main house are the 41 suites that were previously mentioned. It includes two presidential suites as well as one Texas suite. Our suites, as far as the presidential, are one of three upgrade options available for our guests. In addition to the luxury suites, we have two other great options for upgrades that we'll talk about next. So next up is 7. 7 is our adults-only concierge floor. It's designated for guests 21 and over. It's ideal for intimate executive programs, incentive trips, or upgrade options. Upon arrival, guests are escorted to our top floor for a private check-in experience. We're greeted with a glass of champagne. Guests also enjoy a social hour in the evenings, as well as light breakfast options in the morning. And of course, the spectacular views from the lounge overlooking the property and San Antonio. 7 is available for group buyouts, and we can get super creative on how we activate the space from personalization to branding. 7, of course, is going to provide special access with your key card, so designated for exclusivity, VIPs, or simply to enhance that guest experience throughout. In addition to that, guests that are staying on 7 are also going to receive complimentary access, day spa access to Loma de Vida Spa. Lastly, we have the villas. The villas are more of a five-star residential style experience, offers exclusivity, elevated benefits. There's a dedicated team at the villas that caters to each guest's needs, and guests also enjoy a private check-in experience and a personal golf cart to move about the property, in addition to the enjoyment of a private lounge and pool. The villas allow guests to enjoy the allure of a boutique resort with all the extras that a 500-room property can offer. Understanding that full resort buyouts are not an option for all, the villas and 7 are the perfect solution in hosting executive programs, incentive trips, and smaller groups. So guests have arrived. Now it's time for some fun, some relaxation, and there's no better place to start than Loma de Vida. Loma de Vida, again, is our award-winning spa, voted top 5 destination spa by USA Today. Loma de Vida features a curated menu of wellness offerings to include massages, facials, body wraps, and more. And the spa also offers men's and ladies' solariums with saunas and steam rooms, private infinity edge pool and fitness center. And again, as mentioned, guests staying on 7 enjoy complimentary day spa access during their stay. Maybe golf's more your style. Maybe relaxation is for one day and golf is for another. Either way it goes, the resort course is amongst the best in San Antonio, and golfers enjoy some of the most scenic views in the Hill Country. My favorite hole is number 7, where you tee off from the cliff, roller coasters from Six Flags, and the city as the backdrop. Just serves as just a perfect setting for a unique, fun experience for you and your guests. For convenience, the golf clubhouse is only steps away from the main house, meaning no shuttles are necessary to move about between that recreational side of your event. We welcome individual play or group golf outings and tournaments. You might also consider a golf clinic as an activity option for attendees. And as always, we recommend finishing up with a cold drink and grill 254. And speaking of, let's talk about dining options. The resort offers 9 options, sure to satisfy each of your guests' preferences. From our 24-hour Henrietta's Market, to fine dining and signature, and Tex-Mex and Primera Cantina, to healthy bites and juices and quench. And one of the unique features about La Cantera, in addition to that, is that we do still offer in-room dining. In-room dining is available to your guests in addition to these 9 options. So whether it's a relaxing morning or a late arrival, we'll always have something available to take care of your guests. Want to get off property? No problem. The shops at La Cantera and the Rim offer a plethora of dining options, from sushi to steakhouses, and they're all located just outside the resort and easily accessible without complimentary shuttles. So moving into the event space conversation, we're at 115,000 total square feet of meeting space, but we understand that our small meetings deserve love too. And we're proud to say that 90% of our small meeting rooms feature natural lighting and outdoor access. All of our smaller meeting spaces are located on the lobby level of the resort for easy access and only steps away from the ballrooms when being used as breakouts. Our small groups love the ability to step out on the Plaza San Saba for some fresh air, networking, or a good break. So as we look ahead to large meeting opportunities, we offer two ballrooms, one at 17,000 square feet and one at 10,000 square feet. Our planners love the thoughtful layout of our ballrooms, which allow groups to enjoy their respective space exclusively. In other words, your space is your space. The San Antonio Ballroom features a 6,100 square foot covered terrace overlooking the golf course. And the La Cantera Ballroom's foyer space is set with floor to ceiling windows, offering guests unrivaled views and natural refreshment. Additionally, loaded for production is a breeze. With ground level access from the exterior drive, it's never been easier for your team to get set up, whether it's your vendors, whether it's production, whether it's your internal team, easy access and a breeze for your setup. So as you move outdoors, being that we are in the Hill Country, we're more of an outdoor first type of venue so that you can enjoy the beauty of the Hill Country and all that it has to offer. Outdoors also give you benefits to be able to enjoy the fireworks at Six Flags, which is right next door to La Cantera. So first and foremost, we'll talk about Plaza San Saba, but please focus on the fact that we have the ability to entertain in a new space each night between these three venues. But with Plaza San Saba as the first at the list, Plaza San Saba welcomes you upon arrival and embraces your guests throughout your visit. This space features a beautiful water feature and a plaza, which can be lit to align with your brand colors and fully activated for receptions. With existing seating areas and lush landscaping, this space also serves as a wonderful area for guests to easily network. Here we look at Esparza Lawn, one of our favorites, and a blank canvas. This space is perfect for receptions, team building activities, and more. Themed dinners, whiskey tastings, hat bars, and live music are the norm in this space. Esparza Lawn is connected to Plaza San Saba and can be combined for large groups. Next up is Topaz. Topaz is normally our adults-only pool area, but this space is also available for group events. Topaz features an infinity edge pool overlooking the Hill Country and provides the perfect setting for an awesome party. With an existing bar and built-in cabanas, Topaz is perfect for entertaining and a real showstopper for your sponsor showcase opportunities. And finally, our newest addition, the Calera. The Calera is scheduled for completion in December 2024. And brings a whole new level of exciting opportunities for groups. As a standalone venue, the Calera provides an exciting and unique opportunity for groups to experience a different side of the resort. You have the ability to enjoy an off-site event on-site. A seamless indoor-outdoor experience and a dedicated event lawn provide the perfect setting for concerts, team-building activities, and other non-traditional event elements. Furthermore, your event spend is going to contribute towards your food and beverage minimum, and resort shuttles easily move guests between the main house and the Calera, freeing up more time for your guests to enjoy themselves and providing budget relief for the typical off-site related expenses. So as you can see, we truly are a Hill Country oasis within the city, and we can't wait to welcome you as our guests. So we want to thank you for your time today, and we want to thank you for your consideration of La Cantera Resort and Spa.
Wonderful. Jonathan, thanks so much. Did a great job of really packing a lot of information into a presentation today. But, you know, that picture, you know, although it's an evening shot and there's clearly some type of celebration going on, it's probably like every day at La Cantera there in the That's Hill right. Country, but, you know, really a majestic setting, you know, the hillside, rich history there in Texas. And the resort just has such a comfortable, relaxed sophistication. It's been a perennial award winner, right? For everything, for top resort meetings, but you're truly built for business. And what you mentioned there a couple of times, and you've presented really well, both in the accommodation side, you know, nearly 500 rooms, but you have in the layout of the meeting space, you know, 45 plus square feet of space, but lots of different venues, lots of great outdoor venues. I think the ballroom is 10 and 17, you said. So
that's right. Correct.
You know, great space. And, you know, they're designed in a way that you're actually built for handling two fairly large groups that don't feel like they're next to each other just based on the design. So really spectacular. And with these room renovations, of course, you guys were always already in great shape, but you know, big, I don't know what you said, $45 million renovation there. Correct. That's a couple of dollars. I'm sure they're going to look pretty darn nice in the end here. And so the rooms, just quick, the rooms all finished up by January. I think that's the game plan.
That's correct. January 2025 will be fully complete, both with guest room renovations as well as the new Polaris venue will all be in full effect.
Great. So lots of options, lots of great experiences available for groups of all size, but you know, spectacular. I think we saw some great some questions there that were all answered pretty well. If we missed anything, again, we will come back and answer anything that we missed during the presentation or the Q&A. But thanks so much for telling us the wonderful story of La Cantera.
Thank you.
Dana, please take us away to our trivia question.
All right. We have another fabulous giveaway. So trivia time. So the poll is going to be popping up right now. And it's, which popular San Antonio attraction is located just minutes away from La Cantera? There's so many great options. Vote now. Awesome. Jonathan, what is the correct answer?
The correct answer is all of the above. No shortage of opportunities for enjoyment at La Cantera. You can enjoy the city as well as the natural side of the hill country. So we invite you to enjoy it all.
Yeah, options galore. Well, amazing. Well, thank you, Jonathan. Back to you, Jamie.
Yeah, thanks so much, Jonathan, Colleen. Thanks for sharing La Cantera. We all look forward to visiting very soon. Okay, well, let's... last but certainly not least, let's travel back to South Florida to the iconic destination of Boca Raton, Florida, which gets its name from the iconic Boca Raton Resort. So we look forward to hearing what's new with Boca. Katie Jordan, please take it away.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I am honored to be in such great company with the La Cantera and the Pier 66 Resorts. They're beautiful. And we are excited to reintroduce the Beach Club, which will be open in December 2024. However, before we start with the Beach Club, I want to refamiliarize you with the Boca Raton Resort, or actually reintroduce it to you. For those who know it well, and for those who don't know it, I'd like to give you a quick recap. We're located in South Florida, 30 minutes from Fort Lauderdale International Airport, 30 minutes from West Palm Beach International Airport, and an hour from Miami International Airport. So three international airports to easy access of the resort. Our rich history dates back to the opening in 1926. So we are 2 years shy of our 100th birthday. The resort sits on 200 acres. It was designed by Addison Meissner, who blended elegance and timeless sophistication. We actually were acquired by Michael Dell and MSD Partners in 2019, and they have invested over $450 million in the resort in renovation and rebranding efforts. The resort has reemerged as one of the modern masterpieces for both leisure, business, and events. Some of the key factors points to remember about the resort is that we are very distinctive. I think one of a kind in really all of the world, to be honest. We have five different hotels on our property. At the harbor side, which sits on the intercoastal, has the Cloister, Yacht Club, Tower, and Bungalows. We sit with 650 rooms at the harborside, and across from the harborside is the Beach Club, which sits on a private beach with 210 guest rooms. And that's the property I'm going to focus the presentation on. We, in addition to having those five accommodations, we have 15 restaurants and bars throughout the resort, an 18-hole golf course, a nationally ranked racket center with 16 tennis clubs, our courts, 16 pickleball courts, a 170,000 square foot pool club with a lazy river, cabanas, water slides, and of course, we boast the second largest spa in South Florida or on the East Coast with 44 treatment rooms, an extensive garden, and of course, a 50,000 facility space. In addition to that, we have meeting space. We have over 200,000 square foot of meeting spaces. We have grand ballrooms, junior ballrooms, outdoor venues, boardrooms. We're the perfect venue for weddings, corporate events, incentives, anything you can think of, a high-end launch or a investment meeting, we have it all here. But the most important thing about our resort is that we're private. So we have a private membership that gives you access to our private marina, priority dining, curated social events for a 10,000 family member that belongs to a club. So it is quite the playground for anyone that wants to enjoy luxury. Moving on, now let's dive into the Boca Beach Club. The Boca Beach Club is reopening in December after $120 million renovation. It will reopen with 210 stunning guest rooms and suites, two new restaurants, a redesigned lobby along with a fitness center and beautiful oceanside event spaces. As you're going to plan your 25 and beyond events, I'd like you to keep the Boca Resort in mind for any incentive or corporate events ranging from 10 people to 125 people for the beach club. Let's begin with the first impression that your guest is going to have when they arrive to the beach club. This is our brand new porte-cochere. This chic entrance sets the tone for what will be an extraordinary stay. Again, whether you're doing an executive retreat, an incentive program, or just a leisure conference, it sets the tone for a wonderful time. Moving on, once you arrive to our porte-cochere, you enter into a bright and inviting lobby filled with sophistication. It is actually my background and you're seeing it here on screen. Your guests are gonna find a chic cocktail lounge, perfect for unwinding after a meeting or an activity. Along, you'll have an airy cafe where you can enjoy gourmet coffee, fresh pastries. And just outside of the lobby, you have a beautiful terrace, an outdoor terrace that overlooks the Atlantic Ocean. It's the ideal setting for networking, relaxation, or just relaxing with a cocktail. It radiates elegance and serenity. Nothing says, and now we can talk about a little bit about the accommodations. Nothing says luxury like 210 beautifully transformed guest rooms. It offers views of the ocean or views of the residence. In that 210 guest rooms, we have 14 suites, beautiful lanais that walk right out onto the pool terrace. It's perfect for your VIPs or anyone you want to impress in your group, or if it's just for a leisure stay. And this next slide shows what our ocean view room looks like. All the accommodations at the beach club are identical in aesthetics and the size and layout. The only difference are the views. So we have oceanside views and residential side views. The residential side views overlook the intercoastal and, of course, the estate of the resort. Within the guest rooms, we have our private wet bar. This is an extra touch of luxury. Whether your guests are preparing a cocktail or filtered water, the wet bar ensures that the guest has everything they need at their fingertips. And this is in all our guest rooms, all 210. From our lobby to our corridors, they're beautifully designed with natural textures, open spaces, and light. Cool chairs that actually makes you feel calm when you transition from one area to another. The attention to detail is present in every part of the renovation. And if you've been to the Boca Raton since the renovation, you can see there's so much attention to detail. It is actually impeccable. Moving on to our dining options, the Beach Club will have two fine dining restaurants. Here we are looking at Marisol, which offers Mediterranean cuisine. It's a popular choice for breakfast, lunch, and dinner with stunning views of the terrace, a private dining room for intimate gatherings. And of course, on our pool club deck, we'll have Honda. Honda is a Latin restaurant that will offer seasonal menus. So it will be open during high season. And then of course we have our casual bite outlet, which is Ocean Market. That's your grab and go for snacks, soft ice cream. It's perfect for a smoothie. And not forgetting our white bar. Our white bar is also located on the pool deck. So there you can have a relaxing drink under the sun or the stars. And of course, if fitness, this is a shot of our grab and go Ocean Market. And then of course, if fitness is important to your group, we'll have a new state-of-the-art fitness center. It's a perfect way to keep your routine going. We also have another fitness center at the harbor side. So if you want to maybe do a run from the Beach Club to the harbor side, there's also another fitness center at that location. When it comes to meeting and events, the Beach Club offers a versatile meeting space. If you're hosting a beachfront gala, you can do that on our surfside lawn, or you can host your general session in our Atlantic ballroom or our intimate boardrooms. We have four of those on the second floor. All the space have natural lights and it is designed to make an impact. And this is, of course, the entrance to the surf lawn. So we have three different entrances at the Beach Club. You have the main entrance that I showed you that gave you that sense of arrival. Then we have our membership entrance, which is called our coastal entrance. And then we have the surfside entrance, which is the entrance onto our surfside lawn. So say, for example, you are hosting an event at the harborside, but you'd like to have Beach Club or beachfront party, you can take your guests from the harbor side to the beach side and they can experience it both. And with that said, you have access to all of the amenities at the harbor side. So just 5 minutes away from the Beach Club, you can hop on one of our water taxis or our shuttles and you can explore all the other dine-in options. There are 13 restaurants and bars at the harborside for you to enjoy. And as I mentioned, you have the spa, the pool club, golf, tennis, pickleball, bocce, and I can go on. The list goes on and on. It is the ideal destination for an incentive. And in this presentation, you will see a video when it is sent to you of what the Beach Club will look like when it reopens, but we're excited and cannot wait to discuss your events and help you plan an extraordinary experience for your guests. Thank you so much.
Wonderful. Thanks, Katie. Thank you. What a transformation. True definition of luxury, beachfront resort, super exciting. You've been closed for this year. You're opening end of this year, ready for business. And this is a 5-star luxury property right on the beach. And of course, you have the benefit of having this exclusive resort plus the main resort and all the amenities and features you outlined. So really, really wonderful. I'd say that this is the last chapter of Michael Dell's investment into Boca, but I'm sure there's more coming. I think you said 120 million here. I think he's already spent $300 or $400 million upgrading the resort. So spectacular. And I think, as you said, if you think you knew Boca before, you should go see it and make sure you really experience the transformation of the property. Just a couple of quick facts. I saw a lot of questions going back and forth, but just to clarify, 210 rooms mm-hmm. at the beach club. You've got a 4,500 square foot ballroom, some other small meeting rooms as well, but you're really able to handle nice size programs with that 4,500 square foot ballroom. Plus you've got the 6,000 square foot new lawn space, and you've got the beachfront. So there's lots of options for really a more mid-sized group, but you can go up to, I think, 150, I think Jason said there, 150 up to 200 people. So some great options. Along with the balance of the hotel, this is really one of 5 different unique hotel experiences within the main resort. So very, very exciting. Can you talk just a little bit, Katie, about sustainability? You've got a sustainability approach and eco-friendly environment. Is there anything key that you'd like to point out to our guests here today?
Sure. I know resort fee is always a hot topic with groups. It's always a question that comes up. Is it included in the rate, or can you waive it, or can you discount it? Or resort fee actually is a great value. It includes everything that is in your mini bar. So once you step into that guest room, there is beer, wine, snacks, water, all in the mini bar. That's complimentary and included in your resort fee. In addition to that, we have our maid fee or room attendant fee, as well as our porterage fee, which is included. And of course, Wi-Fi is included. So that's a $45 resort fee, and the value is over $100. So you're actually really getting value for the money that you are spending on a resort fee. Because most groups will say, I won't use it because we're in meetings all day, but you're actually able to use it because you can enjoy a snack and not have to pay $10 on your folio when you're leaving. Like, oh my gosh, I just took out a chocolate bar and it cost $10. So it is actually quite a benefit. And that is throughout our entire resort. In addition to that, all our suites have come with hard liquor. So all the liquor is included. So if you want to pick up that bottle of tequila and take it home with you, you can do so. And that's included in your resort fee. So that's a really, I think we provide great value. We want to be seen as a very high-end luxury experience where we're not nickeling and diming you. We're a tipless resort, so you're not obligated to tip anyone around the resort. We want to make it as convenient and as luxurious as possible for you.
Fantastic. And the chance to dip your toes in the sand or the ocean, if you'd like, as well, right? On top of
exactly.
That. Wonderful. Wonderful. Well, thank you, Katie. Let's, Dana, let's go to a trivia.
All right. Well, one lucky attendee is going to be able to stay in that Boca Raton tower. So the poll question is popping up right now. So go ahead and put your answer in. Which of the following amenities is exclusive to the beach club at the Boca Raton? Alrighty, Katie, what is the final answer?
Oh, we offer it all. It's everything. Anything you can imagine, it's here at the Boca Raton. So all of the above.
Amazing, amazing. Well, I know somebody's going to really enjoy that stay and that mini bar. All right, back to you, Jamie, to close it out. Thanks.
Great. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you to everybody for joining us today. We've been excited to learn about these 3 spectacular resorts. Really appreciate everyone's attendance. Thank you to Team Teneo for bringing this production together. And just a quick reminder, we will send out this presentation. So please, if you would like to revisit certain parts or share it with others that you feel would be interested in these fantastic resorts, please do so. And we look forward to sharing. We have a couple more showcases coming up. We will send out some invitations for those, but the Beaches and Islands properties on October 24th, and then a Margaritaville Brand Collection mid-November there. So we look forward to sharing some insights on those exciting properties as well. Thank you all, everyone, for your participation today. Thank you to Pier 66, La Cantera, and the Boca Raton. Everybody have a wonderful day. Stay safe out there. Thank you.
Teneo, ooh, na, na. All of my heart is in Teneo, ooh, na, na. Boutique to luxury, Teneo, ooh, na, na. Beaches and islands, homie, then ski the mountains only at Teneo, ooh, na. Let's talk about the Teneo difference.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh.
20 networking events each year and
oh yeah, oh yeah, oh.
Teneo is built on relationships.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh.
Connecting, meeting planners with the best hotels like
ooh,
300 member hotels and DMCs worldwide.
Ooh,
300 member hotels and DMCs worldwide.
All of my